which is up here. And I want to go to the next one, right? Mm. Which is right here. That's the 13th fret, right? The pattern's really simple. They're in pairs, right? But the 13th fret's also the first fret, right? Mm-hmm. Same note, so you could go use the open string here. See that?
So, this right here, if you were playing it up at the top, that note would be open.
Yeah, and that would be the first fret. Okay. Yeah, I wrote it up here above, just because I want you to see visualize the pattern.
Would that mean, like, for all of these, that they would be open, or just your starting note here?
Just the start, yeah, just these notes right here. So, no, only, like, here, play the pattern really quick. So, let's say you finally have worked your way all the way up here, okay? Mm-hmm. So, you're 13 to 15. So, they're pairs. So, 13, 15. Then 12, 15. Yep, same thing. And then back to 13, 15. Right, you see that mm-hmm. pattern? Now, if you did that down here, it would be right here. Those same notes would be right here.
Okay, so
it'd be right here. Yep.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so it'd just be like that, and then when you would be to the 12th fret on that.
Be open. Right, so that shape is.
Okay, so it'd be.
Right, and then you could go back into that first pattern, which was right here. This guy right here, and then you have the fifth one right here, which I think is actually a good one. You know, when you're just going to play up these mm-hmm. and memorize them, but when you really kind of digest them, what tends to happen mm-hmm. is people really kind of focus on that first one. They seem like they learned that pattern really well, and they kind of the other ones follow later. But what mm-hmm. you should do is, and that's fine, but what you should get comfortable, well, memorize them all, but then really start working with just a couple of them. Maybe work with this one and this one and mm-hmm. maybe this one, because they're close to each other and you can kind of see the relationship.
All right, so basically just start, like, once I get these down, just start getting comfortable with, like, just transitioning into the different.
Yeah, exactly. And, you know, I like to do stuff where you can do licks where you combine the two scales. One thing to know, too, is the second note of this pattern is always the next note in the next one. So this note right here is this note. Right, and this note right here is this note. And this note is this note. And this note is this note. And then it just cycles,
yeah.
right?
Yeah.
Okay. So that's real cool, because now if you're in a different key, so this starts in G, but say we want to start in B flat, we just need to know where B flat is, which is right here, 6th fret. And you would start this whole cycle on the 6th fret. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Then you can play in B flat minor if you want to. So if you're playing with a sax player or something, he's like, let's play in B flat minor. You're like, oh, sweet. You know, you can do that. Right? And so, like, little licks and things you can try doing too once you've had these memorized is just, you know, take the top couple notes, you know. Try playing the scale on just one string. Try and get mm-hmm. as comfortable as you can with it. And you can come up with these patterns. You can come up with patterns to play through them to help you memorize them, whether it be. Going to be hard. You could take the same concept, like that one was. And then try and do that within all the same patterns. It's going to work totally different muscles. It's cool. Kind of mess
with
your
head. What was it?
You want, here, let me show it to you real quick. That's a fun one. It's all within that first pattern, right? Let's play the pattern just up and down. Just internalize that. Yep. Yep. So what I was doing was, that one was. Yeah, that's the pattern, right? You don't even go back to the first note.
Good.
And then move up to. Then go up to this note right here. So starting right here.
Yeah.
So it's like.